miss our conversations. Body language got us screaming through the roof. Yeah, the Bahamas or Jamaica, baby, I'll be your vacation. Let's move. Okay, what's up world? It's your boy Jumarcy here with a video, a quick tip for you if you're struggling to create enough content on your social media as a rapper. Now, this is an issue I'm sure many of you have. I get messages all the time. Even my paid clients are always like, yo, you know, I just don't know what to talk about. I don't know. Or like, I had one photo shoot and all this kind of stuff, and I'm not sure what to do with it. Got one music video, all that. So I really want to just remind you as a quick tip here that you really need to be repurposing content. You need to be repurposing content and repurposing ideas. So what I mean by this is, look, if you have a photo shoot or you get your friend to get their fucking iPhone, everybody has a friend with a pretty lit cell phone, pretty lit smartphone, even if you don't. Everybody goes to a school where you can actually go to the photography department as a student and ask to borrow the DSLR. You should know what that is. Go Google it. Don't know. It's a special kind of camera. That's what we're shooting this on. Blah, blah, blah. Looks like some movie shit. Where you can go and ask them, look, I'm a student. I'm working on my music career. Or you can just lie and be like, I'm taking this class and I need to borrow this shit for a day or whatever. You can get that photo shoot together. You should be taking 10 to 20 pictures, even more really, I don't know. I'm not a great photo shoot person, but take a lot of fucking pictures, all right? And what I want you to do with those pictures is three or four of them are gonna be the ones for your cover photo, for your business card or whatever. I don't even know if people still do business cards. For your business pictures, all that, your LinkedIn, your fucking Facebook, all that stuff. Three or four of them are gonna be the professional ones that you doll up and do a lot of shit with on Photoshop. Now, four to five of those should be ones for your Instagram, for your Insta story. And you can reuse those Insta story ones because, you know, three weeks down the road, nobody's gonna remember that. So you can repurpose your fucking Insta stories and all that. But three or four of those should be specifically for the smaller social media portions that you're throwing out. You go to my Instagram, plug, at How to Rap Drew, you'll see that there's gonna be pictures that look like they're from the same photo shoot, because they fucking are. I think I'm actually wearing the same shit in it. And you're gonna see the darkened picture that was used in my Insta story is now being repurposed as something for an epic quote where I put in the comment a long form comment where I'm saying some real advice and stuff like that. You're gonna see my songs in some of these videos. Even in this, is when I walked in, you heard some of one of my tracks, so I'm repurposing my music. You should be doing Insta videos. You can take a clip of your music video, put it up, and then put some cool new effects on it, or write a story in the comment. Even something as small as a clip from your music video, but a new long, really interesting story in the comment, I mean, not Instagram story, about your career or the shooting of this video is repurposing of content. Similarly, these long comments, your bios, any of your written material, your email list, if you got one of those, you should have one of those. A lot of these little quotes that you're gonna have from these things, they can be your tweets. Now, second point along with this, repurposing all of that. Second part of this is the idea of repurposing ideas. Look, when you have a great quote that you say with your friends when you turn it up, when you say something funny to your mom at the dinner table, when you make the whole class laugh in college with some funny joke, when your homies are arguing about your favorite fucking rapper and you make a really killer point, you should either be writing this in your phone or practice your memorization skills and remember those and make them into quotes, make them into great tweets, make them into little punchlines for your Facebook posts. Like, you need to be repurposing those ideas, saving these ideas and not letting them go to waste, because that's also part of the reason why you're struggling to think of stuff, because you think every single social media motherfucker is just literally like, okay, today is Tuesday. Time to think a brilliant idea for Instagram quote. Or, oh, it's the weekend, so I'm chilling and I'm a little drunk. So now I'm charismatic, put on the camera and I'll say that great line. No, a lot of these people either have teams They got teams of people around, and if your friends support your career, you can go holler at them, get them to hook you up. Or they are really good at memorizing, oh, I said this really clever thing, or I haven't talked a lot about this subject. So my version of this with the how to rap stuff is, you know, I'll go through my day and I'll think, you know, oh, I haven't talked, I mean, in this video, I've said email list. There should be an email list video. I don't think we've ever done one. In the comments, remind me to do that joint, right? So even in this video, I'm giving myself new info. I'm giving myself new ideas. If I don't do the email list video in the next few days, guess what? There'll probably be an Instagram story about it where just for that day, I'm gonna talk about email list. I'm repurposing the ideas. You should be always aware of things that would make for good social media content. Crazy how a lot of y'all out there, especially if y'all over 18, I don't even know what the fucking age limit is, but a lot of y'all spend a lot of time thinking about your Tinders and your Bumble and all this shit, and you'll ask your friends for advice on what's the best fucking bio to get the most girls or most guys or whatever, but you won't spend the same amount of time on your bio, which is supposed to make this career that's gonna change your life and hopefully, if the music's really good, change the world. So you gotta treat this with the same seriousness you would with anything that you're really like passionate about, like sex, for example, on Tinder, or like getting your grades so your mama or daddy don't whoop your ass, right? So repurpose your ideas, keep a focused mind, and repurpose every single chunk of your social media. I don't wanna see just that that tweet. Very common that people are now using tweets and putting them as their Instagrams as well. Like, so if you have a bomb ass tweet, you just white out the top so it doesn't look like a fucking phone, and that's your Instagram post for the day. If it's really epic, if you have a great email or a great letter, put that in the comment of an epic picture of you. If you do a photo shoot, do 10 extra pictures and be like, yo, these ain't even gotta be that high quality because I'ma low and dim the lights and all that kind of stuff and make it kind of blurry, but I'ma say an epic quote. But it's still a picture of you, it's still branding, all of that. So this is not as a quick tip as I thought it was gonna be, just getting in the rambling mode. Wanna do more of these little backlit studio style, just rambling, giving y'all like raw ideas off the top. Hopefully this was useful. Appreciate y'all watching. It's the big homie Drew. And I'm out.
So don't hold back those promises. Say you sick of love with no sinuses. You know my style so prominent. True love is rare like common sense. So don't hold back those promises. Say you sick of love with no sinuses. You know my style so prominent. True love is rare like common sense. Like common. She said you changed. I laugh and I told her that's life. I knew better, so I had to do better. I believe God broke me apart just so I could piece it all together. All year I've been feeling like my days getting cold and short like February.